think you're pretty. Got pretty feet. Got pretty tail. Are you pretty? Well, now you won't talk to me. This guy thinks he's pretty. He knows he's pretty. He's the funny guy. Yeah. He says, you gotta pet me and notice me 24/7. Isn't that right, Tom? Yes. Good Tom. You're spoiled. Yes. Bertha. I know what you want. His morning brushing usually comes with a little sponge bath. And an eye wash. At least an eye boogie pick, anyway. Oh, there, Tom. Can you believe someone had dumped him? He's one of my ferals that I ended up befriending in my garden. Or he did me. He started to come in and then he just decided to stay. Yeah. You go out on the porch now in the winter and you're like, oh, forget that. And he was out there for like 2 years. Unneutered. And so he was a badass at one time in his life. I'm shocked he let me pick him up once when he was really injured to eat and then he just wanted to go back outside. Then I trapped him and neutered him. And the next year, he was my buddy in the garden. Huh. Yeah. He might have been a lost pet, actually, but no one came back for him. No one, no signs, no nothing. And Bertha, you came to me by kids in a kennel on a 101-degree day at my back door. They were saying, please take this kitten. My mom is going to kill it if we don't get rid of it. And then I opened the kennel door to try to check her out, and she flew into my house. Under a table, and I said, okay, well, I guess she's staying. They had done it with another one, Spotty. He was in a wagon. They said, do you want this cat? Same thing. And the lady is notorious for getting pets and just enjoying them while they're young and then not. And I don't want to know what she's done with the 6 dogs she's had in less than 5 years. They're all gone. I don't understand. Some people just get pets for their kids so their kids don't bother them. And then, I don't want to know. Some things are just better left not knowing. So I have